First of all, a big thank you for watching. Secondly, I love making these car videos for you, but I need your support. All you have to do is click that subscribe button. It only takes a couple of seconds, and it means the world to me. All right, here's today's video. Today, five reasons why you shouldn't buy the 2019 Honda CR-V, followed by five reasons you should. The first negative, if it's not broken, don't fix it. There are no significant changes to report on the CR-V for 2019 since the company got so many things right on the 2017 model. You still get the same 1.5-liter inline-four turbo engine on the trim levels above the base LX. The revamped suspension that has significantly reduced the CR-V's former issues with body roll, and the lengthy list of standard safety and infotainment features. So maybe expect a mid-cycle refresh sometime in 2020. Next, a finicky touchscreen infotainment system. Unfortunately, the biggest drawback of the 2019 CR-V is that the touchscreen interface can be rather finicky and therefore not very user-friendly to some people. Some of the controls are clunky, despite the fact that Honda has made few improvements in the past few years, including giving the vehicle a physical knob instead of the former volume slider. Number three, an unreliable navigation system. The optional navigation system on the new CR-V is not terribly reliable when it comes to giving proper directions. Those who buy the CR-V and get the navigation system will quickly find themselves switching over to using their smartphones for navigational assurance. Next, the base trim's engine. While the higher trim levels have the stellar turbocharged engine, the base LX trim is stuck with an underwhelming 2.4-liter four-cylinder engine that gets 184 horses and 180 pound-feet of torque. That is just not sufficient for powering a 2019 CR-V, and the overall driving performance that you get on the base engine lacks the refinement of the upgraded engine. And finally, minor noise interference. If you call that a negative, let's go ahead and call it a negative. It's minor. The smallest gripe on this list is that there are some minor noise interference from the tires and wind, and a barely noticeable amount from the engine until you get it up to full throttle on the highway. Still, the noise levels you encounter are not enough to interrupt music or conversations. They're really only evident when the cabin is otherwise quiet. On the plus side, we have a spunky turbocharged engine. Although the base LX engine does not come at a more affordable price, the upgraded 1.5-liter inline-four turbocharged engine, which is found on the CR-V's higher trims, is well worth the cost. The engine gets 190 horses, 179 pound-feet of torque, and is paired with a standard CVT. A bit surprisingly, these powertrain components work quite well together, giving the vehicle the ability to appropriately accelerate on any roadway. Road manners are its specialty, and many drivers will enjoy how composed a CR-V feels for a vehicle in its class. Number two, a very comfortable ride quality. Speaking of the new CR-V's excellent manners, this vehicle offers an extremely comfortable ride. The 18-inch tires and suspension bushings work well together at absorbing shocks that get encountered in the road. The initial impact is all that you will ever feel, even when you hit a larger or rougher bump in the road. Smooth and sophisticated, the CR-V has no problem providing its occupants with a relaxing ride on road or off. A third positive, a spacious interior. Another aspect of this vehicle that should be attractive to a lot of buyers is the generous amount of space you get on the inside of the cabin. Since Honda extended the wheelbase and widened the vehicle for 2017, the CR-V has been a best-in-class leader for spaciousness. You'll be hard-pressed to find another SUV with as much rear seat space as a CR-V gives, and up front, there is certainly enough room to maneuver around. Cargo space is a plus, not just the cabin, but also the cargo area, one of the most cavernous in its class. With all seats in place, you get between 37 and 39 cubic feet of cargo space. When you fold them down, the max goes up to 75.8. Most compact SUVs struggle to come anywhere close to these measurements, so if cargo capacity is a factor for you, the CR-V might be on the top of your choice list. Last but not least, drivers should appreciate the lengthy list of standard safety and infotainment features that now come on the new CR-V. Since Honda has historically placed a significant focus on safety, there's little wonder that the EX trim and above are riddled, in a positive, with driver aids. Included on that list are blind spot monitoring with rear cross traffic alert, adaptive cruise control, and forward collision warning with built-in automatic braking. Infotainment features include USB, always a plus, and Bluetooth connectivity and smartphone app integration, which comes on the EX trim and above. So to wrap up, the 2019 CR-V continues a legacy of powerful performance. There is no shortage of features to be found on this vehicle, and Honda has gone above and beyond to make sure that the vehicle fits the diverse needs of a wide array of drivers. The amount of space you get is phenomenal, and the level of comfort you will experience makes a CR-V all the more attractive to buy.
All right, that's my video for today. Thanks again for watching. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, please do. It takes a couple of seconds and means a lot to me. Until next time, I'm Dave Erickson with Everyman Driver. See you next time. Adios.
One more thing before you go. I've added links to some of the best-selling automotive accessories on Amazon right now, along with links to some of my product reviews. You'll find it in the description below this video.